Apple just released custom product pages for organic search. And this is a huge deal because it means you can create a set of screenshots for very specific keywords. Take Duolingo, for example, the famous language learning app. They could create a very specific set of screenshots all about learning Spanish. That way, when someone types in learn Spanish into the App Store, the screenshots that show up for Duolingo will be all about learning Spanish and very focused on that specific language. And think about that from a user's perspective. You searched learn Spanish, and one of the apps you see, the screenshots are nothing but learning Spanish. You can see how the conversion rates will go up with these custom product pages. You're much more likely to download that app because it's exactly what you're looking for. Now, we've had custom product pages for a while now if you run paid Apple ads, but if you weren't running paid ads, you didn't have access to this. So the big deal is that now everyone has access to this with organic search in the App Store. And that's a huge deal. So every single app developer needs to be implementing this for their app. In this video, I'll show you how to set it up, give you a couple tips on how to maximize them, and talk about one limitation that I hope Apple fixes in the future. Today's video is sponsored by App Screens. It's a super easy way to generate App Store screenshots with multiple devices and localizations, which is super helpful now that you're gonna need a lot more screenshots for these custom product pages. There's a link in the description, more on them later. All right, let me show you how to set up these custom product pages, and I'll show you the absolute bare minimum that you should be doing, which will take like 5 minutes, and then we'll talk about how you can do more to maximize the potential of these custom product pages. So here I am in App Store Connect, click on apps, go to the app that you want to go to. For this example, we're going to do my app Creator View here. And then now when you're on your App Store Connect page for your app, if you scroll down, well, I'll show you my screenshots. I'm on the 6.5 display, need to update these. But down here on the left, you'll see custom product pages. And at least as of now, there's a nice new badge. Maybe by the time you're watching this, that won't be there, but custom product pages, new. If you click on that, here you can see keywords for custom product pages. You can now assign keywords to each of your custom product pages to make them more discoverable on the App Store. Custom product pages that have keywords assigned to them can appear in search results for those selected keywords. So that's what we're gonna do. If you don't have any custom product pages set up, you'll see this blank screen. If you've already created custom product pages, maybe you ran some paid ads before with Apple Search Ads, you will have them here, but we're gonna create a fresh one. So create custom product page. You gotta give it a name. For this example, we're gonna call this widgets. Now you can create a new page, but you're gonna have to bring in all new screenshots for this. Maybe you want that. For this example, because remember I'm showing you the bare minimum that everyone should be doing, I'm going to copy the existing product page. And the one I'm gonna copy is my ready for distribution. That's the one that's on the App Store. 2.3 is my iOS 26 release. That's not quite ready yet. So we'll create one based on my existing App Store screenshots. And here we are creating our custom product page. So I'll start at the top. You can get a product page URL. So once we create our custom product page, spoiler alert, we're gonna do one around widgets. That's the example I'm gonna use. But let's say I'm talking about widgets on Twitter, or maybe I have a specific landing page all about widgets. And now I have a custom product page where all my screenshots are very widget focused. Well, now I have a link that I can send people to, whether it's on X, Twitter, Instagram, social media, whatever. That way the message is congruent, right? You're talking about how cool your widgets are. And then when they click on your link, they go right to your widget product page. So you get a nice link to that. That's awesome. All right, let's talk about these keywords. So you can see my keywords for Creator View, and this is in your keyword list. This is not in your title and subtitle. That's the limitation that I alluded to earlier, which kind of sucks. Well, more on that later. Let's actually go through and create this. So again, we're talking the bare minimum. Again, the hypothetical scenario is that I want to create a custom product page that is very focused on widgets, like YouTube subscriber widgets, YouTube views widgets, YouTube channel stat widgets. Like anytime someone searches around YouTube widgets, I want to show up with my custom product page. So I'm going to click just widget, because that's the other thing you need to know about this. Each product page, you shouldn't have overlapping keywords. So let's say I did like stat and widget, and then on another custom product page, maybe it was all about YouTube analytics, I also had stat selected. Well, now Apple's not gonna know whether to show the keyword stat for widgets or for analytics, right? So you don't wanna mix your keywords here. Your custom product pages should have mutually exclusive keywords. So for this example, we're just doing widget. That way my widget specific screenshots only show up when someone searches, again, YouTube subscriber widget, YouTube views widget, that sort of search. So if I scroll down, again, click on the 6.5 display because I have older screenshots, you see these are my existing screenshots. What you should be doing is creating two or three more screenshots all about widgets. You can see my widget screenshot has like 8 widgets on it. It's pretty small. If I was really optimizing this, I should create more screenshots that is all about a subscriber widget and is big and blown up and very obvious it's a subscriber widget. Same thing with the views widget, same thing with the channel stat widget. Just really leading into the whole widget thing with the screenshots. Now you gotta be careful because you don't wanna misrepresent your app. I don't wanna create all my screenshots about widgets when my app does a lot more, like expenses, scheduling, money, That was a little too much, to be honest with you, but you get my point. So that's what you should do if you really want to capitalize on this, is create a lot more screenshots for each keyword focus. Now, back to that bare minimum that every developer should do. I'm targeting widgets. So I have a widget screenshot. Look, it's 1, 2, 3. It's the fourth screenshot. It doesn't even show up on the App Store unless they click into it. So the bare minimum is just drag this over to the front, to the top. Just change the order of your screenshots so that the screenshots that pertain to the keyword they're searching for are at the front. Takes 2 seconds. Everyone should absolutely do that as the bare minimum. Because I know creating a whole bunch more screenshots, that takes a lot of work. This takes almost no work. Do this right now. Okay, let's talk about that limitation again, because this keyword list is on my App Store keywords. Now, if you look at my title and subtitle here, I've created before YouTube business tracker, analytics. Now I'm ranking in the top 10 for YouTube analytics. So I would love to have a custom product page all around YouTube analytics. However, I can't because it's in my subtitle. Now I hope Apple fixes this in the future and lets us create custom product pages around keywords in our title and subtitle. Because if you know anything about ASO, that's where your most impactful keywords should go. But currently as is, you can only do this with keywords in your keyword list, but it brings some interesting strategy questions that we don't quite know the answer to yet. So for example, I have analytics as the last word in my subtitle. Would I be better off moving analytics to the first word on my keyword list? That way I can create a custom product page for it and have all kinds of YouTube analytics screenshots, but I'll probably take a hit in the rankings because it's now in the keyword list and not in the subtitle, but then probably leads to higher conversion rates because I have custom product page towards it. So maybe that helps the rankings. These are all unknowns because these custom product pages, brand new, they're just rolling out. We're gonna have to give the industry 6 to 12 months of running long-term experiments, testing this out to see what best practices emerge. But that's getting pretty advanced. I mean, the fundamentals are there. You have access to keywords that you can now create custom product pages for. And the bare minimum, hey, I wanna target widgets. Cool, move my widget screenshot up to the front. But what you really should be doing is creating very specific tailored screenshots to whatever keywords you're targeting in your custom product page. And admittedly, that is a ton of work. All these different screenshot variations, all their localizations, and an awesome tool that helps you easily generate screenshots, automatically localizes them for you, is today's sponsor, AppScreens. AppScreens is a fast and easy way to generate App Store screenshots. To get started, you can use one of their many, many templates. You can use them as is, just drop your screenshots in there, or you can use them as a starting point to tweak, customize, tailor them to your own brand. Or you can use their built-in design tool to start completely from scratch and build your own screenshots from the ground up. AppScreens can localize your screenshots into any supported language. It supports iPad, iPhone, Android devices. It can automatically upload to the App Store, Google Play Store. I mean, look, here's what I had to do before. Look at this giant sketch file, all the different iterations on my App Store screenshots for the Mac, the iPad, the iPhone. And this app isn't even localized. Like, just imagine if I had 5 or 6 languages to go along with all this. Like, it just becomes a complete mess very fast. AppScreens is an amazing tool that handles all this for you and just saves you so much time, especially as an indie dev. So check out AppScreens. There's a link in the description to help you generate all the new screenshots you're gonna need for these custom product pages. Increase that conversion rate, get more downloads, get more revenue. AppScreens will pay for itself.